on the subject.
And for a completely desperate Pakistan, this clearly then looks like perhaps the last resort. Nawaz Sharif stating in his address at the United Generals, in fact, the United Nations General Assembly, that there should be no new permanent seats in the United Nations Security Council. Clearly then he's trying to throw a spoke in India's UN bid.
तो ओवररिएक्शन था ना हमारे ख्याल में, क्योंकि ये कोई नई बात तो नहीं थी, इन हुर्रियत के लीडरों से मुलाकात पिछले 20 साल से हो रही है.
Even before Modi had arrived, a nervous Pakistan resorted to a diplomatic offensive, very well aware of America's growing proximity to the Modi government, well aware of a strong statement by the Indian Prime Minister and the desperation showed on Friday.
The United Nations passed resolutions to hold a plebiscite in Jammu and Kashmir. The people of Jammu and Kashmir are still waiting for the fulfillment of that promise.
Another Kashmir rant came as expected, despite the fact that the UN hasn't debated the issue since 1962. Perhaps he too knew the appeal would go unheard again. But the bigger fear for Pakistan, does India have a larger say at the United Nations?
There should be no new permanent seats in the council. This will be contrary to the democratic character of this world body.
India has support from the big countries. Obama himself backed India in 2010. Britain and France among those who are for it. And the call for reforms in the UN Security Council is getting louder.
We believe that the permanent five members have expressed themselves on reform. Countries like France and UK have positively and directly named India as one of the countries they want to see as a permanent member of the Reformed Security Council. You remember President Obama in his speech to the Indian Parliament has also said that India should be a permanent member of an enlarged Security Council. And I believe that with the other two permanent members, we have been in a dialogue to get them to endorse India's membership as a permanent member of the Reformed Security Council.
India needs 129 votes for this particular reforms to go through, and that's exactly what the Indian side is concentrating on, getting more and more countries on its side. On the last count, about 119 countries had come down to giving support to India. That's 10 short of the magic number of about 129 that the Indian side is looking at.
From the Kashmir rant to an attempt to scuttle India's bid at the UNSC, clearly as America rolls out the red carpet for Modi, Sharif has just ended up scoring one self goal after the other as he desperately tries to please his domestic audience. Bureau Report, Times Now.